swirling away. Either I'm moving fast or time is, but never both simultaneously.
Such a strange paradox. I mean, while technically I'm closer to the end of my life than I've ever been, I actually feel more than ever that I have all the time in the world. When I was younger, there was a desperation, a desire for certainty, like there was an end to the path and I had to get there.
I know what you mean, because I can remember thinking, oh, someday, like in my mid-30s maybe, everything's going to just somehow gel and settle, mm-hmm. just end. It was like there was this plateau and it was waiting for me and I was climbing up it, and when I got to the top, all growth and change would stop, even exhilaration.
Oh.
But that hasn't happened like that, thank goodness. I think that what we don't take into account when we're young is our endless curiosity. That's what's so great about being human.
Yeah, yeah. Well, do you know that thing Benedict Anderson says about identity?
No.
Well, he's talking about, like, say, a baby picture. So you pick up this picture, this two-dimensional image, and you say, that's me. Well, to connect this baby in this weird little image with yourself living and breathing in the present, you have to make up a story, like, this was me when I was a year old, and then later I had long hair, and then we moved to Riverdale, and now here I am. So it takes a story that's actually a fiction to make you and the baby in the picture identical, to create your identity.
And the funny thing is, our cells are completely regenerating every 7 years. We've already become completely different people several times over, and yet we always remain quintessentially ourselves.
Hmm.